I love outtakes.
You sell the green smarts. You sell the bomber fist. Now the gym is back for more. He's got a microphone in his hand. Little Jim is his left hand man. Big Jim. Oh, yeah. Big Jim. Community corner. With Big Jim. Got a microphone in his hand. Little Jim is his left hand man. Big Jim.
This is very comical.
Community Corner with Big Jim.
I'm sitting at a Wendy's. Is this Detroit? Still Detroit?
Why not?
Michigan. It's close to Detroit.
It's not close to Detroit. It's 100 miles from Detroit.
A suburb of Detroit.
I was just told it's 100 miles from Detroit, but it only took 15, 20 minutes to get here. And that was after she paid for the gas. And got to an exit down the highway and said, well, I ain't going to say what she said, but she did say she forgot to put the gas in the vehicle. So we had to go back. So essentially, it took us maybe a half hour to get here. Not counting the swear words and the hand gestures. And well, we'll just leave it at that. But I'm at a car show. I'll show you the cars in a few minutes with their owners. Right now, we're all just kind of sitting around. They're talking like, I don't know what they're talking about. They're going to be talking about parts, when they bought them.
Other car shows,
what they do. And we'll go to their cars, since this is a selected group that sits in a car. By the way, I'm going to show you something that kind of made me wonder about this group when I first showed up. They're all sitting over here on this side. Go ahead and give your name.
Ron.
Ron, yeah, first name is all we need.
Jackie.
Teresa.
There's Teresa.
Sonny.
I'm trying to zoom in on that shirt. Move your arms. See, you can tell we're at a classic car show. Sonny.
Yep.
And Mr. T, is it?
Mr. Lee.
Mr. Lee. And that must be his car right there.
No, it's his car.
Oh, see, I don't know what I'm doing.
I don't know whose car.
Now, I'm sitting on the outside of the parking lot here. They're up next to the cars. I'm by the drive-thru. The cars go right behind me. Not smelling any fumes. No one's honking, tossing cigarette butts out at me. Nothing like that.
Ron's watching your back.
Yeah. And Ron's watching my back. So we're going to continue on their conversation. Don't forget, I host the show, but they're going to be the show. All right, so do you guys come to this place often?
No.
Heard that fast. Was that Sonny? Is that Sonny? No. Where do you usually go?
Across the street.
Across the street. And that's an empty parking lot. What is that over there?
KFC.
Yeah.
Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Knights of Columbus. They're trying to fool me. We're at a Wendy's, so now they're trying to say they go to a Kentucky Fried Chicken, too. So they're going to fit right in as interviews for my show, you know. I leave no bears across. These don't look like any cars that are in the show. But there's one. I don't know what that says. What does it say in the bottom of that car over there? On the door?
Who? That white one?
Yeah.
Thunderbird?
It says Thunderbird. That's a Thunderbird. Now we got another guy just showing up, and I think he's hitting the drive-thru. Oh, he's gonna back up. Get them all showing up now. We got here early. I don't edit my- my show, so hope you can hear me talking. But anyways, got a guy, I don't know. Hey, that's it, he said, hands up. And it's a nice looking Camaro right there. I do know that's a Camaro, it's an SS.
He's from Ohio.
You know,
we didn't know it.
I can remember in Del City, Oklahoma, back in the early 70s, Elton Coyle had some kind of Camaro. But we used to go to the drive-ins. You know, they had the train that brought the food out and everything. And I remember glass packs was a big thing. They had the big tires in the back and glass packs. Those things were so loud that I couldn't hear the crunching of the taco salad that I ate. She's throwing away trash. See?
That was Teresa.
You don't. That's Teresa. You don't litter when you're at a car thing.
No, they don't like that.
They don't like that. Ron is filling me in quite deeply on car shows today. So we're gonna. Main focus is gonna be him. He'll probably tour all the cars with me, and he can explain what's going on because. I'm Big Jim. This show will try not to be as discombobulated as most of them. I will tell you that. No. See, they bring their own chairs. How old's the chair?
It's a chair.
Now, how old is it?
How old is it? 3 years.
It's lasted you 3 years.
Oh, yeah.
You don't get up and down much, do you?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you do?
It's hardly ever get sit in. Still got the tags on it.
Still got the tags. Look, it's got hooks on it, so you can use it as a backpack.
Oh, yeah,
it's got an awning?
It's got an awning on it, too.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Why don't you...
In case you get in the sun.
Jackie, are you the wife, Jackie?
Yeah.
Why don't you help me out and pull that up so I can see how he's covered if there's sun out here or it starts to sprinkle. Go ahead and do his car or his chair. There's a gentleman for you right there. She finishes. So see that, folks? These are $100 chairs or get them on eBay?
Huh?
Get them on eBay? No?
No, we got them.
You paid top dollar, didn't you?
No, it wasn't. How much?
I don't even remember. It's been a while.
Yard sale. They're big here in Michigan. Yeah. We've had three in our front yard since I've been here.
That's kind of neat.
Yeah, so no rain, no sun, snow. You guys come out in the wintertime too, right?
Yeah.
Put a sleeping bag around you.
We go everywhere, don't we?
Ron, do you attach a heater to your battery and put it down by your feet when it's in the wintertime?
No, I just wear nice,
boots.
The good to 20 below zero.
You ever heard of Rocky boots?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what I brought with me from Ohio. That's where they're at, is Nelsonville, Ohio. They're great boots. I step in a river and they don't even get wet.
Oh boy, I might not need it.
I knew.
Yeah.
That worked later.
Can you remember the days when they had drive-ins and they would have a train bring out your food?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that was good in the nostalgia days.
And that's where all this began. These bringing the cars. In a way, that's where it all began.
The good old nostalgia years.
Yeah. So now you're like, you look like you're in your middle 50s.
Yep.
No? All right, we'll leave it at that. Jackie, it looks like she's at least 15 years younger than you. We'll leave it at that.
Yeah.
Sonny, he's pushing 60, folks. I can tell by the beard. Yeah. And I keep saying Mr. T, but it's
Mr. Lee.
General. I'll call you the general today. How's that? Is that a Detroit hat he has on?
Yes.
Oh, God. So we're not going to discuss his age either. We'll just discuss the age of his car. How's that sound? Sound cool? So anyways, you usually go on the other side, the parking lot over here.
Right.
Any other places you usually go to there, Sonny?
No, home in my garage.
The garage. Do you put a cover on it in the garage too?
No.
No? No. Do you start it up once a week?
No.
How often do you have to start it up?
In the winter time, it sits on there. They say if you start it in the winter, the moist gets in the mufflers and stuff, and then they rust from the inside out.
Now we got a heated garage.
I don't have a heater.
I do.
Do you leave the gas tank empty?
No.
How full is it? Full? As full as it goes?
Yeah.
So then you don't get moisture, right?
Stabilizer in it. Nope.
Do you change the oil before the winter?
Nope. In the summer. Before I take it out, I change the oil.
Okay, and same thing with the plugs and points, you check all them and all, or they usually last a couple years?
Have points in it.
I mean, you don't drive these things around just to go to 7-Eleven or Dunkin' Donuts.
Sometimes.
Really?
Well, we McDonald's.
Yeah?
Burger King.
Well, do you wait to eat when you get home? Do you eat in McDonald's or eat in the car?
No,
what?
Eat in the car, that's the fun.
Eat in the car.
You go to a drive-in, do you wait till you get home for you eat your food?
Hell no.
No. I'm referring to just a drive through and you're not hanging around.
We'll eat in the car.
You eat in the car?
Yeah.
As you drive?
Yeah.
Have you got ketchup stains and stuff in your seats I'm going to be seeing or what?
No, pop over our heads.
Oh, it's a convertible?
No. If you want to.
It's got a convertible.
Oh, is this yours over here next to the General?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
It's a 34 Ford.
34 Ford. I wasn't even born to 55.
He said 35.
35 Ford.
Yeah.
That's 20 years before I was born.
It's got a Chevrolet engine in it.
Yep.
All right, before we even go over there, how much you soak into that baby? How much did it cost?
$30,000.
$30,000. And what'd you put in
plus.
It? What'd you put in it?
About $3,000.
So 33.
Right,
so it's worth $33,000 to you?
It'll be worth about $35,000.
$35,000?
Yeah.
Yeah. And that guy there from Las Vegas, the Count, came up to you and said, what would you take, man, for this right here? Because I'm into cars and I love them. What would you take?
$40,000.
$40,000? Come on, you're selling yourself short, Sonny. Stand up. How short are you? We'll take a gander at your car in a minute, all right? Is this your beautiful wife?
Yes, it is.
So?
What do you mean, no?
Disowning him.
Just remember that on your 20.
Is he telling the truth about allowing you and him to eat in the car?
Yeah.
Well, is that your rule?
No, we eat.
I mean, if he says you couldn't, would you?
Yeah.
Yeah. See, he says yes too. Okay, so now you guys have two cars here.
It was her way or the highway.
Her way or the highway. Yeah, I've been told that a few times.
Way or the
highway. Why do you think I'm in Michigan right now? No. You two brought two cars, correct? This is your little second, honey. She's the apple of your dreams. This is the peach of your heart, right?
You better say yes.
Hey, what did you bring?
Corvette.
Oh, she's got the vet right next to me here. What the gander at the engine?
86.
That's an 86. Oh. Okay.
And the Grand National.
The Grand that's Ron's. We're gonna check yours out first. All right.
Alright.
Yeah, we're gonna stand up. We're gonna stand up and take a tour. Is that right?
Okay, stand up.
No. Hang on. I need to have a little bit of my root beer, my Dr. Pepper first. I'm gonna smoke a cigarette.
Hell, I'm ready.
That's right. I smoke.
Smoking around.
I smoke. And just in case, I knew I was coming to a car show, so just in case, I brought my electronic cigarette. So if I want to smoke around their car, I don't have to worry about ashes, smoke, odor, and it's recharged completely. Community Corner with Big Jim. Be right back with Ron and his Grand National.
Jackie smokes
Buick.
Here.
Oh, wait a minute.
Jackie smokes.
Jackie smokes in the car?
Everywhere.
Ooh.
Everywhere.
That's a Michigan rule, folks. You can smoke in your car no matter what year it is.
No, unless you've got kids.
Unless you got kids. That's a rule everywhere. And folks, you already know I brought that up a few times. The seatbelt issue is a different story. Community Corner with Big Jim in Michigan, somewhere near Detroit. They won't really tell me how far.
I don't have no seatbelt.
And
I got shoulder harness.
We'll be right back and we'll investigate some of the vehicles here with these interesting Michigans. Go Buckeyes! All right, now we have a Thunderbird here. And we got Lee. I call him General Lee. Now, what year is this?
1960.
A 1960. And look, it's got Thunderbird right on the That came just like that when it came out, huh? So, I like the top. And the window with... They used to call that the air conditioner.
Oh, yeah.
You used to open them babies up, and that was your AC for the day.
Yeah.
That I remember. Power windows?
No.
No? No, they didn't have them back then. They did have bucket seats, though. That's real leather in there, isn't it? Oh. Yeah. Now, explain the middle. Some people would call that a console, I guess.
Yeah, it's a console with a shift on the steering wheel.
The shift is on the steering wheel, so that's four, right?
Yeah.
You go all the way, come back all the way up for reverse?
All the way, yeah.
Yeah, I forgot what car it was I had, but I had one of those. So why don't we open up the engine? What do you have to do? Is there a thing that you have to...
352.
It's a 352. Let's take a gander at it.
Yeah.
Do you have to open the door and pull something?
Yeah.
They don't make cars like they used to, folks. Now, on your brights, is the thing on the floor?
Yeah.
That you push?
Yeah.
You don't pull back on the wipe or whatever, or turn signal.
Yeah.
There's a button on the floor. I remember. Whoa, yeah, we're going down. Yeah, we got Sonny with us. Sonny's good. It's kind of windy out here, folks.
Don't want to stay out.
Sonny's going to hold the. Boy, they don't make them like that anymore. That's a size what?
352.
A 352. Nice and clean. Did you have to do any mechanic stuff to this? Or is it just.
A little bit, not too much.
What'd you have to do? Just as far
up.
As the motor goes.
Full tune up on it, more or less.
Full tune up. We got another gentleman over here taking a gander. Beauty, isn't it? Yeah. And now you can close her up. So that's all you really soaked into this was a tune-up? Lee? That's all you really soaked into this was a tune-up?
Yeah, just about a major tune-up, more or less.
The paint job's the same?
Same. Yeah.
So what about the tires, the white walls? How many tires have you had to go through?
No, this is the tires that come with it, you know.
Really?
Yeah, they're new tires on it.
Now, how many miles, well, actually, when did you get this? How many years ago?
About 2 or 3 months ago.
2 or 3 months ago, and how many miles would you say you put on it?
58,000 original miles on it.
58,000 original.
Yeah.
Now, I noticed you got the rear view mirror here. There's not one on the other side, though.
No.
They only came with one?
They only came with one, yeah.
You do have a real beer. Oh, he's got the dice, too, folks. Gotta have the dice.
Gotta have dice on it.
Yeah. You didn't have to replace any. Do you know if all the windows are original?
Yeah.
So, did you buy this from a little old lady?
No, but it does have a little crack on the windshield there. I mean, it's hard to notice, but...
Right. But who did you purchase this from? A little old lady or?
No, I got it at a dealership.
At a dealership?
Yeah.
I'm not going to ask you how much you paid for it because I know that's a few bucks.
No, it was a dealership that sold old cars. You
know? Oh, okay. So you just kind of walked in and said, this is the one I want?
They had like 15 or 20 old cars in there.
And out of those, this is what you wanted?
Yeah.
Is this what you were originally looking for or you didn't really have one in mind?
Yeah, that's what I went down to look at, you know, and I ended up buying it, you know.
But you looked at the other ones first.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Had no second thoughts.
No.
All right, let's take a... Now, this is when they had the fender skirts, too.
Yeah.
My dad's Olds 98 had those.
Yeah, it was like a half skirt. So.
Yeah. His were a lot... On the Olds 98, they were a lot wider than that.
Yeah.
You know, you got your Thunderbird there. All these light up?
No. Still got the little fins on it, yeah.
Yeah, look at the fins, folks. Three red lights in the back. One's brake, one's a blinker, and one's reverse. Look at the fin. Yeah. Thunderbird in the back. License plate just says historical.
Yeah.
The number really has nothing to do with it, right? You got your key on you? Let's see the trunk.
Pardon?
Your key on you? Let's see the trunk. I want to see how big the trunk is in this baby. Oh, scratch on this thing.
Oh.
Again, they don't have the rear view mirror on this side. Are those blinkers on the front? Do those blink? Do those blink, those lights up there, Lee? The lights on your fender up there, do those light, do they light up when you're
pre- No, no, no.
No? Just for looks, huh?
Just for looks.
Yeah. Wow, no rust. That's a good sized trunk. Yeah. Your jack and everything's probably behind the wheel, right?
Right.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Well, you could throw a lot of luggage in there.
Right. Oh, it's a big trunk for us, for a roadster, you know.
Leave that one alone. Okay. All right, so there you go, folks. There's the first one of the night. It's a beauty. And General Lee's quite proud of it. All right, Community Corner with Big Jim. Be right back with, looks like a, it's a roadster, I think. I don't know. We'll be right back.
Hello, Facebook friends. Big Jim does not play casino, lucky slots, Farmville, or any other game on Facebook. If you continue to harass him by requesting so, he said to go poke yourself, because pokes are cool. Keep it real.
All right, now I said this was a roadster earlier, but I'm sure I'm quite off on the name of the car.
Check the headlights out.
It says Street Rod. So it is a roadster, right?
No? No, it's a street rod. It's
a roadster. Is the light
light there?
Yeah.
It's a school bus light.
Is that your turn signal?
Yeah, all sight.
Yeah, let's take a gander at the lights. I don't see them on.
Yeah, they're on. The
bottom. Oh, the bottom's on. All right. Are those like parking lights?
Yep.
Okay, those are,
there's the
yeah, those are parking lights on. Okay, now, as the Thunderbird over here, if you want bright lights, the button's on the floorboard, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. They don't have them on the turn signal or pull back, you know what I mean?
No.
So, what year is this?
35.
It's a 35. Now, did you do, oh, can we open up this even more? Look at that. It's even got holes for you to do some. Did you do all this, or?
Yes. My wife and I.
So, what was there before you put that?
Just a plain black wall.
Plain black
firewall.
Okay, now what about all this chrome? Was it like that?
It was like that. I painted the blue.
Painted the blue?
Yep.
Inside the chrome. Did you polish all the chrome
yes.
up, or was it like that?
No, I polished it all up.
What was that can right back there? It's red.
That's the coil.
It's a coil?
Yep.
What's the
that
coil?
That makes a spark, so it'll run.
Oh, like a distributor cap.
Right.
I can see the top of it now. Okay. There's the throttle. See, I know a little bit about it. Folks, there goes the phone. Never amazes me when I'm... That's my doctor. I can always call them back. size engine?
It's a 400.
That's a 400. Is that what they call a four barrel?
Yep. It's Holley four barrel. 750.
Okay. What's this hose here for? Is that
the radiator?
That's radiator
hose.
And it's a small radiator. I guess they didn't make them that big of these things, huh?
No.
No? Now on his, he only had one side bear.
Yeah.
You have two.
Yeah. Well, these was the add-on I added them on.
Oh. What did they have before?
Probably just one single mirror.
Just
on
like his over there?
If it had any.
Huh?
If it had any.
If it had any. What's this down here? What's
Pro
35?
Yeah.
What's that represent?
My tires in the back. Is that white?
So that's what that means?
Yeah.
Kind of advertisement?
Yeah.
Did you do the pinstripe?
Nope.
That was on there.
It was already all on there.
Same with the paint. You haven't repainted. Okay. Again, no power window, folks. No ashtrays. And,
get the headlight.
Two people could sit there. But it was made for one, I take it?
No, it was made for... It don't have a trunk, and it had a full seat. But that's how wide the tires are from there over to here.
That's why they call it a roadster, right?
No, that's why they call it a Pro Street.
A Pro Street. And then you just push down.
Yep.
And these things. Here's the bucket seats. Same steering wheel as you got it?
Yes.
You think it's original?
No.
No? You have to talk to that lady over there on my behalf. She's the boss. What's this thing here in the middle? Tachometer?
Yes.
That's a tachometer. Does have a cigarette lighter.
That's for the cell phone.
Cell phone use. What's the toggle switch on top of the cigarette lighter?
For the electric fuel pump.
That's for the electric fuel pump. Again, who's this, four-speed?
Automatic.
Oh, it's an automatic. Now, was that an automatic at the beginning?
No.
No?
It was stick shift.
Yeah? Did you change it to automatic?
No.
You got it automatic.
I bought it just like it sits, almost.
Almost like it sits. Now, again on here, see, this is what I'm referring to when I say you want to turn on your bright lights. You got to hit that button on the floor. Most new cars don't have that feature. Now, they did have a little pocket thing for you.
Right.
Was that added on, or you think that came original?
It's added on.
Wow. So, obviously, all this was added on, right?
Yes.
Somebody soaked some money into this.
It's got,
before you got it.
It's got suicide doors. They open backwards.
They open backwards. You see that, folks? You don't see that too often either. Now that's original.
Right.
Okay. Go ahead and shut that. We're going to go to the rear. And
no trunk.
Again, the Pro 35. Should get out of the... Now, yours doesn't say...
That's historical.
Yours says historical.
Right.
Yours don't.
That's an original 1935 license plate.
1935.
And you're allowed to register them in Michigan.
So you can keep that same plate?
Yep. Never have to buy another plate or nothing.
And this is a 35, right?
Right.
So, who bought that plate before you, do you know? Or did you buy it?
I bought it. It came out Port Huron. The guy sells them up there for $45.
$45 you had to pay for that, and yep. Then you just, when you get it registered.
Yep, registered to.
You don't have to get a new one.
The state.
Now, what's with the Just Us?
That's our car club.
Your car club. You can see, folks, it's on his shirt. Huh? Just muscle cars.
Just a bunch of friends.
Can you open up the back?
There's nothing there to open up.
It doesn't open.
It don't have a trunk.
Wow. Hey, you mentioned that inside.
Yeah.
So you have the brake and turn signal.
Right.
Does it have a reverse light on it too?
No.
Okay. So you, no parking?
No.
Just strictly brake and signal?
No, it's got the parking lights on the bottom. The two little red lights.
Oh yeah, same as the front.
Yep.
Now, is that the gas tank?
Yes.
So that's where you fill her up?
Yes.
And how big is the gallon? How big is the tank?
13 gallons.
Ooh, that's big for back then, I would think. Wow. Do you like the small window?
Yes.
Yeah?
You can see yellow.
Yeah. Now, there's a handle on it. Is the window open?
No, that's a third brake light.
Oh, that's a brake light. So that's an add-on too then?
Yes.
No, and that's brake. Inside. It's not outside. Kind of hard when it's sunny out here, you got shades on. See, the lights came on. Well, so, not only do you get the ones down here, you get there. Same handles on here. Now, he doesn't have the... Oh, yeah, he does. He does have the... on here. And here's the other light. And again, you said that it may never have had any kind of mirrors on it.
Maybe the rear view mirror.
And that's about it, huh?
Yeah.
How come you don't have dice on yours like General Lee?
I don't know.
One of these days, right?
Actually, if you get caught something, if the police wants to be,
yeah,
they can give you a ticket for having stuff in your...
Dice and stuff, yeah, like that? Have you told General Lee about that? He's not over there anymore.
He's right here.
But you can see right there what I'm talking about. We don't want to make him nervous.
No.
We're not going to bring it up. So, how big are the front tires?
They're 15s.
Those are 15s. As you can see, this is a...
You can probably see, you can't bend down.
I'll tell you what, take my camera. Here's my camera, man, they're a dime a dozen. And show the folks how wide the babies are. Yeah. And how wide? 35, is
yeah,
there?
Yeah, 35.
What do you do when you see a fly in the car? You don't smash it and put it in the paint, do you?
No.
All right. So, have you waxed it yet?
No, it's been waxed. I just cleaned it up today. This also got the original. This was a wooden roof up here back in then, and they vinyl the top.
Vinyl. But there's wood underneath that?
Yes.
Wow. So there was wood up there at one time. Have you seen the wood?
No, you can feel it.
I can see right,
like,
there,
right,
yeah.
Here.
Do you like the vinyl, or would you rather have the wood?
No, I like the vinyl.
Yeah. Easier to maintain, right?
Right.
All right. Sonny, thanks. All right, now I cut off too soon. Sonny says, would you like to hear it run? After the camera's off. So Sonny's going to start her up for us. The dual exhaust. That don't skip a beat. That don't skip a beat. What do you think about the that stepping in?
Pardon me?
That right there?
Oh, I like
that
it.
You step on?
Yep.
Do you like that?
Yeah. I like it.
If it wasn't there, would it be hard to get in the car?
No.
No?
That's the way it was made.
Do you think you ever put, like, some kind of strip on it?
Oh.
Because it's in the garage in the wintertime, so
right.
It's never going to be icy, right?
That's right.
Yeah. Sometimes I remember some of the stuff they say, sometimes I don't. We're going to let Ron take us on our next tour.
Go ahead, Ron.
Hang on, I need some more Dr. Pepper first. I'm starting to sweat. You know, I don't like doing manual things. Community Corner, Big Jim, I'll be right back. Before I even post this on Facebook or put it on my TV show, I know one of the responses is going to be, Jim, you have too much time on your hands. That may be so. But it always is good to ponder and get the brain working. Here's a little overtime that I figured I'd throw in with the rants. And, I don't go out and do that much shopping. Usually have other people do it for me. When you're Big Jim, I demand some assistance. I do have rights. But anyways, I was at the nearest Kroger's, and all of a sudden I look over and, well, we've all been shopping at one point or another, I'm sure, and you have your big carriage, and then you have the basket in case you're not doing a big shop. You just want to throw a few items in. And then now they have a mini carriage. It's like half of the big carriage. So it's a little bit more shopping than what you would put into the basket, I guess. Look at this thing. So you have the large basket, the medium well, the large carriage, gotta get things right. The large carriage, the small carriage, and the basket. So, if I ask you to go shopping for me, I only will require enough for the basket. Rants! No, wait a minute. This is Overtime with Big Jim. See, now Ron's smart. He stays in the shade. When I was talking to them, the sun was in probably glare. Couldn't see how old Sonny was. You know, he did it on purpose. So this, I almost thought this was a Keystone Light chair, but it's not.
Nope.
So they're his and hers.
They're his and hers.
His and hers. Or actually, they're hers and his, right?
Yeah.
We got to get it right.
That's true.
Okay, now what are we taking a gander at here again?
87 Buick Regal Grand National.
87 Buick
Regal Grand National.
Regal Grand National, intercooled.
Yep.
What does that mean?
Huh?
What does intercooled mean?
Because it's got that great big intercooler right there in the grill.
On the grill?
See through there? That's a great big intercooler. Keeps it cool.
Oh. Did that come stock?
Nope.
No.
I had to put that on.
You did?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's talk about the motor a little bit since we got... First, I want to let you folks... This is the first thing I noticed. How it says Buick turbocharged. Now, you told me the last time that they made that was when?
87.
So it came with the car.
Yeah.
Staying there.
Yeah.
Is that original part, you think?
Yep. That's original.
So it hasn't... They don't make them since then.
They made them 85, 86, and 87. That's only
three years.
They made the Grand National.
So, vintage. Vintage. All right, now what size?
3.8 turbo.
3.8 turbo. Is that an 8-barrel?
Nope, 6-cylinder.
6-cylinder?
1,500 horse.
Man, how can that be possible?
It's possible.
What's added extra to it?
Because of that turbo.
Because of that. Did you add that?
Yes, I did.
So, it was just the regular engine here when you bought it?
Yep.
It didn't have the turbo.
It didn't have none of that stuff.
Was there a reason why you wanted the turbo?
Yeah, fast.
It's faster. How much?
Oh, way faster.
Well, what would you say, you know, say in 10 seconds, how fast would it be up to?
Well, 8.40 seconds was 185 mile an hour and a quarter mile.
What's the fastest you've been in this?
185 mile an hour and a quarter
185,
mile.
Really?
Yeah.
Were you on a track or?
Yeah, that drag strip.
Wow. What kind of filter is this?
K&N filter.
What's it for? The turbo?
Yeah, it filters the turbo out real well.
So all that came together then?
Yep.
And was this chrome on this, on the radiator?
No, I added all the chrome.
Added the chrome. Now you told me you bought this when?
89.
You bought this in 89.
Yep.
You hadn't bought any before it.
Nope.
And you don't plan on buying any after it?
Nope, just right here.
And I said, you must love this car.
I do.
And you said, almost as much as I love my wife.
Yep.
Yeah, that's what I heard you say. So, what's this tachometer, right? What's that tachometer?
Your boost.
Boost on your turbo?
Yep. How much boost you're putting out.
Okay. Now, you got two things here. What are the caps on the tops? What are those things?
That's your oil caps for oil.
So you put oil in each one?
Yep.
Okay.
It's got an 8-quart oil pan on it.
8-quart.
Yep.
What's that little red box up there?
The MSD ignition. Electronic ignition.
Electronic? All right, and overflow with your radiator.
That's the overflow.
So you add a lot of chrome to this.
Oh, yeah. Got GN1 heads on it.
Did you add that tachometer thing too then?
Yeah, I put all that stuff on it.
And did you do all the mechanic stuff or did you have?
No, I had a lot of it done.
Yeah? You're like me and...
Yep.
Not lazy, just you want it done right.
Yeah, because a lot of mechanics can't even work on these cars because they're so, they don't even want to touch a Grand National.
So when you find one, you keep them.
Yes, I got a regular mechanic who works on just Grand Nationals.
You getting special stuff for Christmas?
No.
No?
No.
Just pay them good, right?
Just pay them real well.
Right. So what size tires and rims are got on the front?
Just 13-inch.
13-inch?
Yeah.
How many tires have you gone through since you've had this?
Two sets.
How many miles you put on it?
I don't think there's
estimate.
I don't think there's 9,000 miles on the car.
Nine?
Not even that.
And this is the original engine?
No, it's been all rebuilt, though.
Oh,
it's all rebuilt.
So there's only 9,000 miles on this
car?
If that right now. So it's only a two-door.
Yep.
What size are the back tires?
Them are
15s?
950 15s, 11 inches wide.
Did you buy the rims and everything, too?
Oh, yeah.
So you changed them?
Oh, yeah.
What was on there before you?
Just the stock rims.
Which would be how big?
They're just 15 inch.
15. So same size, but.
But these are a lot bigger and a lot wider.
Yeah. Now, go ahead and explain. Be cool. What's.
That's the radiator. Be cool radiator.
Okay. And then we got the autometer. That's for the turbo.
Mickey Thompson. That's the tires.
The tires. Bad day racing is better than a good day working.
Yep.
Do you live by that rule?
Yes.
Yeah. Have you raced this thing?
Oh, a lot.
Yeah?
Yes.
And have you ever won?
Oh, yeah.
You got trophies?
I never lost.
Are you serious?
Never lost.
You got trophies?
Yeah, I got a basement full of them.
Do you ever do street racing where you pull up to a light?
No.
And a guy runs his engine?
No, I just laugh at him.
Do you?
I figure, why should I waste my car? There ain't nothing he can do to me.
Why waste fuel or the rubber on your tires?
It's basically got turbo blue in it. Yeah. It's $8 a gallon.
So they're idiots to want to, yeah.
Okay. I just look at them and laugh.
Yeah. Okay, the IHRA, we all know what that is. Comp cams.
The cam.
And then we got the Grand National.
Four-race roller cam.
Going fast with class. Did you put that on?
Yep.
All those stickers you put
up.
Hey, open her up for us. Now, on the other two cars that we just seen, the bright lights. If you wanted to hit your bright lights.
Yeah.
Is the knob on the floor?
The shifter?
The little button you push with your foot to put the brights on.
Oh, yeah, it's down there on the floor.
So you have one in here, too?
Yeah.
That would be stock.
Yep.
I can't see. It's probably underneath the carpet, right?
Yep.
Okay, it's underneath the car. What's this? A roll bar?
Roll cage.
Did you put that in?
I had it put in. You have to have it.
Do you have to have it for
racing? You have to have it when you're anything run over 150 mile an hour. You got a roll cage and a parachute.
Whether you race or not.
Mm-hmm. Oh, if you race at a drag strip, you don't have to on the street.
Right.
At a drag strip, that's the rules.
And that's what you do is race at drag strip?
Yeah, that's all.
Yeah. Okay.
You got to have a fire extinguisher.
Is that the original? You have to have a fire extinguisher, too?
It's it right there on the floor, the white thing.
What would require you to use that?
In case it rolled over and caught on fire.
So nothing really out of the engine?
No. In case it rolled over and caught fire.
On the track?
Mm-hmm.
You may not have time for the trucks to head out there. And
that's for sure.
Yeah, now, I'm sure you have to wear a helmet.
Yep.
Right?
Wear a helmet.
Is that in the car too?
No, it's at home.
Yeah. Original steering wheel?
Yep.
You can tell it's well worn.
Yes, it is.
So that's original.
That's original.
What about these things here? These
gauges
tachometer or whatever?
They were all added.
Those were added. Same with the middle?
Yeah, them little ones on over there, I cut them into the dash in there. I put them in it.
So those weren't there? No. Got an 8-track?
No, I have no. I can't hear a radio.
Is there a radio in there?
Yeah, there's a radio there, but you can't hear it.
No, because it's too loud.
Yeah, it's original radio.
You're going to start it up in a few minutes, so we'll know what you're talking about.
It's original radio.
So original bucket seats?
Nope.
No?
No, them are race seats.
And what was in here before?
Just the regular seats. He's got the holes in it for the harnesses and all that stuff. There's the harnesses. You got the belt that goes around your waist. You got one that comes up through the groin and everything.
So I take it you have someone in the car when you race sometimes?
Nope, just me.
Well, why do you have it set up on the other side too?
In case I take somebody for a ride on the street.
And you want to?
Yeah, just go off like
that. You want to hit like 60
like
or 70?
I got a car show.
Yeah.
Take somebody. There's no back seat in it.
So Proctor by Scott, that's.
Yep.
Yeah. All right, that's cool. And no back seat?
No back seat. It's all carpet all the way up the back.
Can you lift the seat up? Does that go forward?
Not very easy.
I want to see what the back looks like. He's even got it on his jacket. You're cool.
If you can see in there, that's far as you go up.
Oh, yeah. You put the light on, too, here.
It's just all carpet all the way up.
See that, folks? Roll bar.
Yep.
Wow.
Safest car you can drive.
Turn the light off now. So, that's all padded.
Yep. Get your head on it.
That's not padded, though. No. Don't really need it padded.
No, you don't need it down there.
Yeah. Now, when you shut this, do you just kind of...
Yep.
Gently?
Nice yeah. And tight, yep.
All right, now, do you need the keys to open the trunk?
I got them.
He's got them on him. I always like to see the trunk space.
It's a fuel cell. It's got the battery in the back.
Wow, the battery's in the back. I never noticed it wasn't up front.
No. Always in the back on a race car.
So you installed that too.
Yep.
So this really wasn't a race car when you bought it, was it?
Little thing there to put something in if you want to put something in there.
A little luggage or first aid kit, maybe.
First aid kit.
And this is for the turbo?
It's a fuel cell. There's no gas tank in it. That is the gas tank.
That is the gas tank.
Yep.
And high test?
Yeah. Turbo blue.
Turbo blue.
110 octane.
Can you get that at any gas station?
No, it's hard to find.
Where do you go?
I go to one on Dixon. Let's see, what the hell is it?
Would they be all over in Detroit?
I don't know. I've never had down in Detroit.
Yeah, I don't blame you there.
I can't drive it that far. It burns too much gas.
How many miles do you get per gallon? Just say around town.
Going really nice, maybe four.
Are you kidding?
No.
Wow.
And that's keeping your foot off of it.
Now, when you're drag racing, it's just down the line, do you hit the lights, whatever. How much gas do you go through doing that? Do you have to fill it up on the way home?
Oh, yeah, you got the 5-gallon can of gas with you.
Just in case, huh?
Oh, yeah, because I'm burning a whole tank of that up in just two runs.
So there's not many places that sell the gas, then?
Nope.
They must like customers like you, then.
They do.
That much money?
They do.
Wow. Okay, now... anything special on the license plate?
That's the original 87 license plate. Okay, that's all tubbed out underneath. It's got a complete Moser axle in it, 35 spleen axles. It's got ladder bars and adjustable coilover springs. Yeah, that's the original plate for 87.
Doesn't play well with others.
Nope.
What does that mean?
Doesn't play well with others.
And hell yeah.
It's fast.
It's fast. You got the Grand National everywhere, yep. Huh? So that's the original license plate.
Yep. It's one come on in 87. Never have to put another plate on.
And these are
wheelie bars.
For dragging. Now, is this where like a parachute comes out or something?
Yeah, I put the parachute right on the back to here when I take it to the track. It snaps on the back.
And you just pull the cord from inside?
Yeah, cable right straight through, and I just pull a cable.
How well does that work for stopping you quickly?
Oh, yeah. When chute comes out, it gives you a jerk.
Really?
Oh yeah.
Like a G-force?
Oh yeah, that's why you got them shoulder harnesses and all that stuff to keep you tight in the seat.
Do you use the brake much when you use the parachute?
Not until after you use the parachute. That slows it down enough where you can
Then you start using the brakes.
Yeah.
Wow. Is it dual exhaust?
Yep.
What's this off-on switch?
That's a kill switch.
What is
it? Tips over, you run out and shut that off so the fuel won't catch on fire.
And that's why you had the extinguisher.
Right.
Okay. So, got your keys?
Yep.
What about the stripes in the window?
That's just a rear defogger.
Did it come with it or did you do it?
No, it came with it.
Did it?
The heartbeat stops here. That's for Chevrolets.
That used to be their old slogan? Or?
Yeah.
So that's original?
I put the heartbeat stops here.
And now these are the same as the other side, right?
It's all the same.
All the same. Well, here's the exhaust.
Yep.
The other one's on the other side, I take it.
Yeah, that's the pipe, 4-inch pipe.
4 inches.
Yep.
Does moisture come out of it?
No.
No? No?
72 Q trim.
What's that?
72 Q trim all reworked.
72 Q trim?
See, it says turbo.
You can get under there.
Yeah.
Say what now?
You get under there, it's a dump tube under there where you take that. Undo it and it runs right directly off the engine instead of the exhaust.
Wow.
See it?
No, not really. You want to take the camera?
Right there.
Here, take the camera and put it right on. If you want, you can look right there.
Hit this.
Yeah. And what does that do?
It runs directly from the engine when you undo it.
For the kill switch?
Huh?
Is that to the kill switch?
No, that's to make the car run. That gives it more horsepower.
Oh, okay, I got you.
You're cutting out the exhaust, you run straight off the engine.
Wow. Now, what's this, mean?
Club.
That's your car club?
Roman Chariots.
Is that the club you belong to?
Yeah.
Yeah. How long have you been in a member for
10 years.
10 years. All right. So, that's a beauty. I can see why you love it.
It is. I love it.
And, how long do you think you'll own it?
Until I die.
Yeah.
Who's
going to get it when you're gone?
My wife.
The wife. The boss. Thanks, Ron.
Okay, thank
now
you.
Now it's time to do the boss.
There you go.
Community Corner with Big Jim, right back. We got the boss. This is Jackie. And she's pulling the hood, and Ron, the other half, lifts it up. So, with the headlights, I take it.
Roll out.
Now, what size tires are these, Jackie?
I don't know much about it.
Nope.
I have to
Ron, you're gonna have to come back over here.
It's her turn.
No, we got
questions.
No, the reason is I just got this inherited to me from my dad when he passed away.
What size are the tires?
Them tires?
Yeah.
I don't even know what size they are.
I just got it.
I don't mess with this. I just mess with my own.
Okay. Do you know the size of the engine?
Yeah, it's a 350 tuned port injection, 425 horsepower. Jack, you should be
Clean
down
something.
Here doing this.
What's that?
I told Jack you should be down here doing this.
Yeah. Well, let's just call them really big tires.
They're big.
Yeah, they're not 15s. No, they're not 15s. Now, is this from the Indy race car? Is that the hat you wear sometimes?
That is my dad's hat.
Your dad's hat. So you keep it in the car.
In the car.
Yeah. Was he there at the 86 race?
He probably was.
Got it for you.
Okay.
The 275 by 402 are 17 inch.
17s.
Yep.
They look pretty new, too.
Yeah.
I mean, you barely see any tread.
Nope, we just got them.
Scuffed on that. I see you use the stuff to keep them shiny on the outsides.
Yeah.
All right, let's go ahead and open it. It is a convertible where it's like a T-roof. The glasses come off. Anything you do inside, or did it come this way?
It all came this way.
This is all original. And this is a what year?
86.
86, folks. Looks nice and clean. No A-track. You guys, nobody has A-tracks.
It's not an A-track.
No, it's not A-track. That's a CD player.
She's got a CD player, folks.
Yeah.
And she can hear it when she drives.
Yeah.
And that's her automatic. Now, when you turn on your brights, do you hit the switch on the thing, or do you have the floor thing?
Nope, hit the switch.
You have to hit the floor.
Nope, on the dash.
Oh, it's on the dash.
Drink.
Yeah, see? It shows it's not that old. Yeah. Are the back tires the same size?
Yep.
Wow.
17 inch.
All right, what about this license plate?
It's an original.
That's a big thing with the car people is try to get the original, huh?
Yep.
You never got to pay for it again.
Nope.
Now this is a quadruple dual, or it's not dual exhaust because there's four pipes. What would they call that?
It's dual exhaust, but it's just a thing that goes over and makes it look like it's got two pipes on each side.
Does it make it louder?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Go ahead and start her up. Start her up for us. It's got the fin, aerodynamic, right?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. She looks great in this car.
I'm glad he didn't have me start mine. It burns too much gas.
Well, you know, you're starting yours next. We forgot all about that. Give her some gas. Are those glass packs? Are they glass packs? They are, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. It reminded me from Oklahoma. Whoa. All right, go ahead and start yours up there, Ron. While we got the camera rolling. Nice. You could eat off of this engine. That's how clean it is.
Too much gas.
Too much gas, he says. So he's only going to start it up quick, folks. He's going to put the harness on and everything.
Now that you hear it, it's a fuel pump. Got a 1,000 horsepower fuel pump in it.
All right, here we go. Can you give it one rear up? That's all he wants, folks. That just cost him $10.
Yes, it did.
Yeah. So, all right. Hey, this has been great.